Hi guys, welcome to Daily Technical Forex Forecast for the 7th of June. My name is Andrew Chinesky. I'm a technical analyst at TrimFX, and traditionally we begin our forecast with the EURUSD Currency Pair. As you can see from the chart, after the strong growth of the price after the release of the payrolls, the pair is trading in a local consolidation inside the level of resistance 1.1264-1.1279. If we take a look at our volumetric chart, you see that corrections was on small volume, and you see that this volume was concentrated at the bottom of the smooth. So, and after that, we saw a continuation of the growth. So you see that this level contains large volume, so it's a cornerstone for trading the euro. Its breakout will be a great signal for opening long positions, because we have a strong uptrend, and of course it supports purchases scenario. So the plan of trading the euro is pretty simple. We need to wait a confident breakout of this level, and then we open long positions. A stop loss should be set below the breakout bar or the beginning of the breakout move. A potential of the deal is around 90 pips. So for the euro, after the breakout of the resistance, we open long positions. If the price continues trading here, or in this consolidation, or shows a correction of the price, we should stay out of the market, because trading against such a strong uptrend is a silly scene. Our next instrument is a Great Britain pound. Well, you can see that after the breakout of this level, the price showed a correction, and then is trading in this level, the level of resistance 1.2899, 1.2913. So our scenario remains the same. We need to wait for a final breakout of this level, confident breakout, and then we can open long positions. A stop loss should be set below the breakout volumetric bar or the beginning of the breakout move. A potential of the deal, a target is the level 1.3040. So for the pound, long positions are in priority. If the price corrects down or continues trading here in the consolidation, we just stay out of the market, because we need to get an additional signal that bulls are dominating the market for this instrument. The Japanese yen, well, the price showed a strong fall, and it's now also falling down. So of course, given such a rapid local downtrend, we should consider opening only short positions, but we need to wait for a correction of the price to get an acceptable stop loss size, and of course a better risk profit ratio. So after the correction of the price, which should be smooth and without or on small volume, we open short positions here and wait for further fall of the price. A potential the deal will be around 100 pips after the correction, and this deal is pretty interesting, but as I told before, we need to wait for a good entry point for the Japanese yen. The Canadian dollar, our scenario is totally confirmed. After the test of the breakout point, the price fell down, and now it's going down. Of course, in such a case, our main scenario is opening short positions. So we wait for a smooth correction of the price, open short positions, and wait for further fall of the price. Stop loss should be set here, so above this test, and the potential of the deal is around 90-100 pips. So for the Canadian dollar, also short positions are in priority. The Australian dollar, well, our scenario also was totally executed. We saw a strong uptrend move, and of course this move also broke the previous maximum, and you see that the breakout was on increased volume. It was supported by ask deltas, which means that bulls were dominating the market, and we see a sharp candlestick here. So all factors are for continuation of this growth. So of course, in such a case, we need to consider opening long positions. So we need to wait for a smooth correction of the price, Then open long positions and wait for further growth of the price. Stop loss should be set below this breakout volumetric bar, and the potential of the deal is around 80 pips. So for the Australian dollar, long positions are in priority. And our last instrument is gold. Well, we need to open volume chart to get a better view of this instrument. We saw a strong growth of the price, and then this move was stopped by pretty large volume. You can see it here, and now the price is trading in this local consolidation. You see that this consolidation, this range contains pretty large volume, and we see you see that we need to highlight a new level of resistance. It's 1295.10. You can see it here on the Forex chart. So this level is crucial for trading gold, because it's also a higher boundary of the consolidation, of this consolidation local. So the scenario is pretty simple. We expect the continuation of this growth, of the uptrend, and of course we need to wait for a confident breakout of the resistance, and after a smooth correction we open long positions and wait for further growth of the price. A stop loss should be set below the breakout volumetric bar or the low boundary of this consolidation. A potential of the deal is around 150 pips. So for gold, after the breakout of the resistance, long positions should be in priority. Let's take a look at the sentiment of the market. Well, overall, this indicator totally confirms all our scenario except the Canadian dollar. So I advise you to be extremely careful trading this instrument. You see that situation here is 50-50, but all other instruments are confirmed. So for the euro and for the pound long positions, for the yen short positions, for the Australian and gold, Australian dollar and gold long positions should be also in priority. So you see that now the market gives us plenty of opportunities to trade currencies. The best deals for today are the euro, the pound and gold. The yen and the Australian dollar also can be traded, but after smooth corrections to obtain a better risk profit rate and entry point. So for today is all. Hope this forecast will be useful for you. Thanks for watching. See you. Bye bye.